Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we can see spontaneous generation. In ancient times, it was believed that life originated spontaneously from non-living matter. Aristotle proposed a hypothesis which states that some vital force is responsible for creating life from inanimate objects. Spontaneous generation, it is also known as abiogenesis. Some examples are given here. That is frog, it is coming from mud. And this mice, it is coming from dirty shirts or dirty clothes. Similarly, flies came from decaying meat. These are the some of the observations in spontaneous generation theory. Many experiments were conducted for disproving the spontaneous generation theory, and the first experiment was conducted by Francesco Redi. He was an Italian physician and poet, and he attempted to disprove the spontaneous generation theory by conducting an experiment using decaying meat. He took three containers. First container was kept open, others closed. One is cork sealed and other was covered with gauze. After that, he observed, and during his observation, he found that the maggots developed in the open container, that is on the meat surface of the open container, and there is no maggot formation in the second container, which is cork sealed, and the third container, we can see maggot appears on the top of the gauze, and there is no maggots inside the container in the third case also. Thus, he found that the maggots appeared only in the opened container. Thus, he concluded that the meat, decaying meat, is not capable of producing life. Second experiment was conducted by John Needham. He was a priest. He took some chicken broth and heated it. After heating, he let a flask cool and sit at a constant temperature. Then he found turbidity in the flask. It was a strong proof to Needham of the existence of spontaneous generation. He said that a vital force is responsible for life. This is the experiment conducted by Needham. That is, the chicken broth was heated. It was kept open. After some time, turbidity was observed. And his conclusion is that a vital force is responsible for supporting the spontaneous generation. Next experiment was conducted by Lazzaro Spallanzani. He attempted to disprove Needham's experiment by repeating his own experiment by making some changes. He boiled the flask longer time. Then he also sealed the flask. And he observed. And he kept the flask outside and he observed. There is no growth or there is no turbidity in the flask. That is, on boiling, the microorganism in the flask disappeared or they are killed by boiling. Rudolf Virchow, he also challenged the spontaneous generation with his concept of biogenesis. He also said that the life is arising from pre-existing life, but he has no experiment or he cannot convince this with an experiment. He presented his idea to scientific community, but he cannot prove it experimentally. Next, Louis Pasteur. It was in 1861. A French scientist by name Louis Pasteur demonstrated that microorganisms came from pre-existing life, that is mainly from air. He demonstrated that the microorganisms exist in air and can contaminate sterile solutions by passing air through cotton filters. And the filter can trap these tiny particles or microorganisms in the air. And this filter can cotton filters can contaminate sterile solutions. He filled a number of short-necked flasks with beef broth and then boiled their contents. And he immediately sealed the mouth of the flask and left them. And some of them were left open and some of them are closed and allowed to cool. After a few days, he observed that the unsealed flasks were found to be contaminated with microorganisms and there is no evidence of growth in sealed flask. Pasteur concluded that the microorganisms in the air were responsible for contaminating the broth. That is, the broth is the non-living matter present, so these microorganisms are contaminating this non-living matter so that the growth appeared. Here we can see Pasteur filled a flask with medium, heated it to kill all life. All life forms are killed first by boiling. After boiling, he drew the neck of the flask into a long S shape or curve. This is by simply heating the mouth of the flask, he drew the neck of the flask into a long S shape or a curve, and this flask is called swan neck flask. And this swan neck prevented the microorganisms in the air from easily entering into the flask. And he found and he observed that there is no growth in this swan neck flask. Then he broke the scan this swan neck flask, that is the head of the flask. That is, this swan neck was broken and he made neck was opened, and after that he kept it for some time and he found growth inside the flask. This is because the microorganisms in the air can easily enter into the flask and can grow and make the solution turbid. Thus he found that, or he concluded that, the microorganisms present in the air is responsible for growth, and the life will not exist from or will not generate from non-living matter. Life is originating only from living matter, and this is the theory of biogenesis. That's all for today. Hope you all understand the session. Thank you.